Hey guys, welcome back to Java Collections Framework series. In this video, we create ArrayList class example 4, that is different ways to remove elements from an ArrayList. Let's switch to the Eclipse IDE and let's create this example. Let's go ahead and let's create a class. Right click on a package new and then choose class. And let's give class name as RemoveElementsArrayList. And then choose public static void main method and hit finish. And in this example, I'm going to demonstrate the usage of remove method and then remove all method and then clear method. Okay, so let's go ahead and let's see how we can use these three methods to remove elements from the array list. First of all, we are going to create object of the ArrayList list. So make sure that you choose a list from the java.util package and then pass type as string ArrayList of type string and just give the reference variable name as brutes and then ArrayList. Okay, let me quickly add few elements to the ArrayList. Let's say banana, apple, mango, orange, pineapple and grapes. So these are the few fruits I have added to the ArrayList object by using add method. And this element is present at index 0 and this is at 1 and this element at index 2. This is at 3. This is at 4 and this is at 5. And I have provided sysout to just print this list. So let's go ahead and let's run the program and let's see the output. Yeah, here we go. So we have printed all the list elements to the console. Now let's go ahead and let's use a remove method to remove a particular element from the list. So I am going to remove the element pineapple at index 4. So let's go ahead and let's use a remove method. Let's call brutes object and then call the remove method. So look at here, there are overloaded remove methods. First one is remove method. It accepts integer as a parameter, and second remove method accepts object as a method argument. Okay, we're going to first check this one, first remove method, and this remove method accepts into index. So we are going to remove the pineapple element at index 4. Let's go ahead and let's pass 4 as an index. Okay, and here I will provide a sysout to just check whether this element is removed from the list or not. Okay, after removing element at index 4, how the list looks like. Let me run the program and let's see how it looks. Yeah, here we go. After orange there is a pineapple, right? So pineapple element is removed from the list. Okay, great. Now let's go ahead and let's use another overloaded remove method. I'm going to call brutes and then remove. So look at here, we have demonstrated first remove method, right? So here is another overloaded remove method. Let's call it is, let's use that one. And here I'm going to remove a mango which is at index 2. All right, and let me just provide sysout here. After removing mango element at index 2, okay, and just run the program. Yeah, here we go. So look at here, after banana, apple, there was a mango, right, in the list. The mango element was successfully removed from the list. So this is how we can use a remove methods to remove element. So this remove method is basically we use to remove element at a given index. In this we can use directly, we can just pass a element to the remove method to remove that particular element from the list. Now let's go ahead and let's see how to use a remove all method. Okay, so remove all method we can use to remove a collection of fruits. Okay, for example, if you want to remove a multiple elements from the list, then you can use remove all. For example, I'm going to remove two elements from the collection. For that I need to create a collection over here like this. So look at here, I have created a array list object and I have added apple and banana. Okay, and I want to remove these two elements from the main list. For that I have created sub fruits list object. So I can pass this object to the remove all method. So remove all method will remove these two elements from the fruits. Okay, just create a array list object and add apple and banana elements to it. And here I'm going to call fruits dot remove all method. So look at here, remove all method accepts collection as a method argument, and we can pass sub fruits list as a method argument. After that I will print a list to the console. Let me run the program and let's see the result. Yeah, here we go. Apple and banana is removed from the list. We can able to see only orange and grapes. So this is how we can use a remove all method. So if you want to remove a bulk of elements from the list, then you can use a remove all method. So one more method is there, that is a clear. So we can use a clear method to clear all the elements from the list. So let's go ahead and let's clear the array list object. I am going to use clear method to remove all the elements from the list. After clear, if I print the fruits object to the console, it should print empty. Let me run the program and let's see. Yeah, here we go. Okay, so we can use a clear method to remove all the elements from this list. So this list will be empty after this call returns. Okay, great. So we understood the usage of remove all and clear method of array list class. Okay, so whenever you want to remove something from the array list, then you can use these methods.